is to the Treasurer, and it is how much has been spent so far on the Building What Matters campaign, and what criteria has been used to afford this campaign promotion in South Australia to date, given he chairs the relevant committees.
Treasurer has the call.
Mr President, I'm happy to take the detail of the question on notice, but the Building What Matters campaign, together with all other campaigns, there is publicly disclosed on the government website the proposed cost of the campaign, the actual expenditure of the campaign, and a copy at the end of the campaign of the evaluation. That is what it was endeavouring to achieve and whether it achieved it or not, and that's publicly available. That occurs at the end of each campaign, so I would need to check to see whether the evaluation of the first stage of the Building What Matters campaign has been concluded or not. I suspect it might not have, but nevertheless there is a process where those sorts of details are all made publicly available. Nevertheless, I'll check to see what is publicly available and advise the member accordingly.
Thanks. As a supplementary.
Supplementary, Mr President. Why has this campaign been approved and what behavioural change does it create?
Treasurer. Well, I ask Franks to repeat the question.
Why has this campaign been approved and what behavioural change does it create?
Treasurer.
Mr President, again, the details in terms of the evaluation, the purpose of the campaign are revealed publicly, but in broad terms, the government's position was that, particularly, Mr President, as we were seeking economic recovery, particularly as in particularly the last 18 months, I guess, with both an economic stimulus package and the need to save as many jobs and businesses as we could in terms of the impacts of COVID-19. So that was obviously an overlay for part of the campaign, Mr President. That was important for the people of South Australia to understand where their hard-earned taxpayer dollars were being spent on very important social infrastructure, such as massive amounts of investment in hospitals and health facilities right across the board that the Minister for Health has been talking about in this chamber, very significant expenditure on schools and education facilities the Minister for Education has talked about, and again massive expenditure on transport and road projects in particular that the Minister for Transport has been talking about. So, Mr President, public sector investment in public infrastructure is critical in terms of jobs and businesses and economic recovery in South Australia, and advising people, A, of where their hard-earned taxpayer dollars are going, and the value of that is one very important policy goal, Mr President. But secondly, also advising businesses that may want to tender for important public sector infrastructure projects and being aware of the pipeline of projects that are flowing is obviously another very important policy goal that taxpayers will be very much interested in, Mr President. But as I said, the precise terms of the evaluation and what's meant to be achieved will be made available if they have not already been made available. This government has been transparent in terms of government advertising. The costs of the campaigns and the evaluations are made public on one of the government websites.